Did Paul McCartney subconsciously get the idea for one of his most enigmatic songs from a gravestone? It seems there's quite a tradition of drawing inspiration from greenfields peppered with ancient upright stones. No man drowned in memory gently sleeps through the dust in vain. The great thing about the cut-up technique is that you can get your source material from anywhere. You don't need to be a billionaire. David Bowie openly admitted using the technique to help him come up with the lyrics to many of his hit songs. But he didn't invent it. In the true spirit of the process, he pieced together his own interpretation from avant-garde writers and artists of the past, taking text, cutting it up into words and phrases, and reassembling it to trigger an endless number of new possibilities, reminiscent of the way that life recycles itself. Just imagine, there are more ways you can arrange a standard set of playing cards than there are atoms in the world, which is like the polar opposite of most standard puzzles and school questions that have only one correct but contrived answer. So what I've done is I've concatenated a series of epitaphs and inscriptions from headstones in my local graveyard and cut them up into words and phrases and then put them into an old tankard that belonged to the Sportsman's Inn pub in Hythe that sadly burned down in 1907. Gently shake and see the words naturally tumble out into fridge magnet-like poetry. David Bowie said that he used the technique to ignite his imagination. So it doesn't matter if it's not perfect. In fact, the more nonsensical it is, the more amusing it is. And in the rare instance it does actually make any sense, you've unwittingly created a work of art. Once touched, the night gently sleeps 16 years, love and peace, and no man who gave the lamb fresh thoughts to obtain the earth. Memory realms drowned in the dust follow me in vain. Patiently along the lingering steps arose my spirit. If you can crack the meaning of that, please let me know in the comments, because I haven't got a clue. And on that note, here are some more videos you might want to click on after you've hopefully rated this one.